Welcome back to the Palak Azoria. It's finals time on day three of the sparring. Plenty of athletes and locals have come back in for the finals. These will be the weight categories where they'll be contested. We have the men's lightweight first up. Calmly making his way towards the mats, Amohir Mohammed Bakshi, standing in his way. A fighter who got through calmly. He's done it in style. Victor Asp from Norway is one cool customer. Bakshi and Asp will then be taking to the mat. Islamic Republic of Iran with a medal on every day of the sparring so far. Can Bakshi get another one? Bring one home for the Islamic Republic of Iran. He's in blue and the Norwegian Asp is in the red. 15 seconds remaining in the first round. Bakshi tries to keep the distance to then fly off a back leg kick. No points in the first, but both fighters with a little more data to go off for the second in how their opponent likes to fight and how they're approaching this final. Amongst other things, Victor Asp in the red for Norway, competing to win Norway's first gold of these games. Not got off the mark in terms of the golds. Asp carrying all those hopes here. 2 points, though, go the way of the Iranian, first of all. Then he goes upstairs for the head. Doesn't quite have the range, and Asp backed away cleverly. See our referee encouraging the fighters not to be passive, to engage. Punch coming in and landing. Asp off the mark. Is so happy in the middle distance, as it's called. The distance within which both of each other can easily reach out and strike your opponent. Neither trying to back away when that distance is breached, and the Iranian moving 4 points ahead. 3 points clocked. Asp needs to stay in touch. Won't be too worried if the gap is just four going into the third round, but can't let the opponent in blue get too much further away. Both these fighters doing well at the recent World Championships in Manchester. Asp going through to the round of 16. Bakshi on the way to the quarterfinals. Upstairs goes Asp, and then it's returned by Bakshi, doesn't land it. Just 10 seconds remaining in the second. Really good round from Amir Mohammed Bakshi. Looking for more as the round ends as well. Asp comes forward, but it's the Iranian who takes another three. Well, stretching the lead. The fighter in blue just taking a shot at the end there. Gold medal on the line for the Islamic Republic of Iran. Be their fourth in the Taekwondo arena. Bakshi flying out with that front foot. See, that flip doesn't seem to carry much conviction when it goes forward from Asp, but with the range he has, it can cause problems, and was well avoided. Eight points the difference, and Bakshi will be conscious that with 80 seconds still to fight, that is so much time to come back for Asp. Asp turns, looks for a second action. Bakshi with significant advantage as the final minute enters. Keeping his discipline is the Iranian. Coming in to shut down the attack from Asp. From here, he really doesn't need to do too much, just can wait and try and pick off attempts from Asp, but he's going for headshots still. Seconds left. And for Bakshi, inside the final 30 seconds, needing a break from proceedings. Getting up gingerly. Takes a gam jump for going to the floor. Makes it marginally an easier job for Asp. And he can't hang around here, the Norwegian. Can be no delay, needs to start scoring big. Shoots one out, and that fantastic evasion from the Iranian. He'll take another gam jump for use of the knee. 6 points the difference. Shooting off with the front foot, then spinning forward. Still, the difference is there though, and Bakshi edging closer now to the gold medal. Comes in for the clinch and then eats up another few seconds. Amir Mohammed Bakshi with a punch to win it. A punch that seals the gold medal. Well, he was bold and brave throughout. He didn't sit on any lead. Kept adding to it right until the end. And Amir Mohammed Bakshi from the Islamic Republic of Iran takes the gold medal.